Today, we are gonna fix FIFA 23 secure boot is not enabled on this machine problem. Before moving on to the video, don't forget to leave a like. Our first solution is to run FIFA 23 and EA application as admin. If you are entering the game through Origin instead of EA, you need to do this for Origin. To do this, right click on our app, then click Properties. We click on Compatibility, and from here, we click run this program as an admin. After doing this, we click apply and click OK. We do the same process for FIFA 23. This was our first solution. Now you can check if the problem is solved or not. Our second solution is to uninstall and reinstall the EA anti-cheat. For this, right click on FIFA 23 and click open file location. Then click on installer folder. We click on EA anti-cheat. Then we double click on EA anti-cheat installer. Click on this icon and select FIFA 23. Then click uninstall. As you can see, the uninstall is complete. After uninstalling, we close this window. Now we are gonna open our game and the anti-cheat will be installed again. After opening, we run the FIFA. In the window that opens, we click on reinstall EA anti-cheat. EA anti-cheat is installed. We click play. As you can see, it worked without any problems. This was our second solution. Our third solution is to remove anti-cheat application that we use except for EA anti-cheat. Someone recommended this solution on the EA forum. He mentioned that we got the error because EA anti-cheat conflicted with other anti-cheat apps. To remove other anti-cheat programs, we type control panel in the search. Click on uninstall a program under programs. Here are the applications available on our computer. We will remove anti-cheat applications such as Riot Vanguard and Face It on our computer. Right click on anti-cheat programs and click uninstall. Click yes in the window that opens. In the same way, we remove other anti-cheat applications on our computer. This was our third solution. If our third solution didn't work either, we will move on to our fourth and final solution. Our fourth solution is to enable secure boot if it's not enabled on our computer. In order to enable secure boot, we need to enter the BIOS of our computer. Depending on the brand of the computer you are using, your BIOS key and your BIOS menu may be different. To learn the BIOS key, we type the brand of our computer and BIOS key in the browser. As you can see here, it says which key it is. You can learn the BIOS key by typing the brand of your own computer. Now we will enter the BIOS to enable secure boot. After opening the BIOS, we come to the boot from the top menu above. You may also have boot options. As you can see, it says enabled next to secure boot. This option is probably disabled for you. We need to enable secure boot by pressing the enter key. We enable secure boot. In addition, if there is Windows UEFI in the boot mode section, select Windows UEFI. If there is no Windows UEFI, just select UEFI. After making these settings, we come to the exit on the top right. From here, we select the save and shutdown option or exit saving changes. In this way, our settings will be saved. And that was our fourth and final solution. We have come to the end of the video. I hope one of these solutions fixed your problem. If the video helped you, don't forget to like the video. You can also subscribe to my channel to support me. Take care and see you in the next video.